Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
Welcome to the Easter service here at Sir Thomas Butler Church of England High School. It's great to spend some time together thinking about the real meaning of Easter. Easter was 3 days that shook the world, but it was the culmination of a plan that began 33 years later at the birth of Jesus. But actually, it was all a plan that began from the very beginning of time. Back in the Old Testament, the first half of the Bible, the prophets spoke about all that would happen at that first Easter. Here are some readings from the prophet Isaiah talking about what would happen 700 years before it actually happened. Listen as a head boy and head girl read to us from Isaiah chapter 53.
Who has believed our message, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? He grew up before him like a tender shoot and like a root out of dry ground. He had no beauty or majesty to attract us to him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by mankind, a man of suffering and familiar with pain, like one from whom people hide their faces when he was despised, and we held him in low esteem.
Surely he took up our pain and bore our suffering. Yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions, he was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all.
If Sky News had been running on the first Good Friday, this is the sort of thing that perhaps they would have recorded and reported on the 15th day of the Jewish month of Nisan, AD 29.
we celebrate the resurrection and hail the risen Christ when we kneel before the rugged cross where Jesus gave his life. We lift our hands in total praise and give thanks to God above for the great sacrifice he made to declare his unfailing love. If we look back to Calvary, where Jesus was crucified, we can see his nail-pierced hands and the wounds in his side. We marvel at Christ's suffering and give thanks for his sacrifice, because it was for us that Jesus died, so we could have eternal life. But God raised Jesus from the dead, and with gratitude we can say, our sin debt has been paid in full, so we celebrate Resurrection Day.
The birth, the death, and the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ are the foundations of the Christian faith. This song, which is going to be sung to us by some of our own fellow pupils here at school, speaks about Jesus Christ being the cornerstone. Never more than this year, 2021, have we needed stability and security and certainty. And it's found in the words of this song, in Christ who is the cornerstone.
Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they're doing. and they divided up his clothes by casting lots. The people stood watching, and the rulers even sneered at him.
They said, "He saved others, let him save himself, if he is God's Messiah, the chosen one." The soldiers also came up and mocked him. They offered him wine vinegar and said, "If you are the king of the Jews, save yourself." There was a written notice above his head which read, "This is the king of the Jews." One of the criminals who hung there hurled insults at him. "Aren't you the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other criminals rebuked him. "Don't you fear God," he said, "since you are under the same sentence. We are punished justly, for we are getting what our deeds deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus answered him, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise."
On the first day of the week, very early in the morning, the women took the spices they prepared and went to the tomb. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb, but when they entered, they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were wondering about this, suddenly two men in clothes that gleamed like lightning stood beside them. In their fright, the women bowed down with their faces to the ground, but the men said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here, he is risen. Remember how he told you while he was still with you in Galilee. The Son of Man must be delivered over to the hands of sinners, be crucified, and on the third day be raised again." Then they remembered his words.
I might be showing my age a little bit, but I remember two films. One was called Three Men and a Baby. The other was called Four Weddings and a Funeral. You may not remember those films. But today I want to talk to you very briefly about two men and three ladies. First of all, two men. Charles Dickens began his famous book, The Tale of Two Cities, with these words. "It was the best of times, it was the worst of times." And that sums up Good Friday, because the Bible tells us that crucified either side of the Lord Jesus were two criminals, two men. They both saw Jesus. They both heard Jesus. They both experienced what Jesus was experiencing, but they responded in two very different ways. The first one rejected everything he saw and heard, shouted, cursed, swore, full of pride. The other man's reaction was so different. Humble, confessing that he'd done things that were wrong. He repented and received forgiveness and salvation. Two men, one rejecting the offer of life, one receiving it. But then there were three ladies. Move forward just 3 days, and they're going to a tomb that they expect to be filled with a body. And when they get there on that first Easter Sunday morning, the stone is rolled away, the tomb is empty. And then they hear the most amazing words. "He is not here, he is risen." It's rightly been said that the greatest news in the whole world came from a graveyard. Here were these three ladies. Jesus had promised that he would die and rise again, and now he has. He's not here, he's risen. There were two men. And there were three ladies. I wonder where you find yourself in the story. You see, the truth is, we're either one or other of those two men, rejecting the truth or receiving the truth. And either we like those three ladies, filled with joy and gladness at the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ, or we walk away shrugging our shoulders. In 2021, of all years, don't we need new hope? Living hope? Don't we need a new beginning? Don't we need a new life to start and the start of a new life? That's what Easter's all about. A brand new start, a whole new world, a big change that came around because the tomb that was filled is now empty. I wonder, will you consider Easter for yourself? Will you decide which of those two men you are? Will you decide whether you'll respond like the ladies when they went to that empty tomb that first Easter Sunday? Why not give it some thought? Why not give it some consideration this Easter?
Oh, 3 days went by, again they came to move the stone, to bless the slave with oil and spice anointing. Hallelujah. But as they went to move the stone, they saw that they were not.
Promise of this joyous time of year bring peace and happiness to you and those you hold most dear. And may Christ our risen Saviour always be there by your side to bless you most abundantly and be your loving guide. In Jesus' name, Amen.
Dear God, how can we ever thank you enough? You endured more pain, more shame, more sorrow, more grief than we can possibly imagine. Help us remember why you gave your life. In Jesus' name, Amen.
Heavenly Father, thank you for sending Jesus to save me from my sins. Thank you that you love me enough to send the perfect sacrifice so that we could live together eternally. In Jesus' name, Amen.
Lord, how can I ever thank you enough for coming into this world to give your life for me? I am sorry for the times I get so busy that I fail to remember the incredible love you demonstrated to me by going to the cross. In Jesus' name, Amen.
Dear Jesus, I plead for you to give me your grief over the people who have missed you and rejected you. This Easter, remind me just how much I need you. Give me your heart for my world to see the desperate need for salvation we all have. In Jesus' name, Amen.
Lord, help me tell of your wondrous power and mighty acts for those generations that come after me. May I not let the season pass without pondering the real meaning of Easter. In Jesus' name, Amen.
God made you and God made me. He made the world for us to see. God loves you and long ago he sent his son to tell us so. Jesus showed us many things, to love and share and dance and sing, to learn and pray, to help and care. He promised he'd always be there. He died but then came back to life. Let us celebrate for he's alive. In Jesus' name, Amen.
So Easter is not just a point in the calendar. It's a time for personal reflection and personal consideration. A friend of mine who's also a school chaplain based in Liverpool asked a number of Christians what Easter means to them, and this is what they said.
Hi, I'm Hannah and I work for a church called Christ Church Liverpool, and Easter to me means celebrating that God has rescued me through Jesus dying and coming back alive, and I know that he is with me now and that I will live with him forever.
I remember as a kid, my next door neighbours used to get loads more chocolate eggs than we did, and somehow they managed to make them last till about summer, or at least it seemed that way anyway. For now, as an adult, more importantly, Easter reminds me of how amazing Jesus is and how there is no one like him.
Hi, my name is Mike Wildsmith. I'm a church leader in Warrington. To me, Easter means death is dead, love has won, and Christ has conquered. Death is defeated because Jesus is risen. Love wins. Our greatest enemy, death, is defeated by the greatest love of all, sacrificial love that gives us forgiveness. And all this is bound up and secured in a person. Christ has conquered. Easter tells me Jesus is alive. He is risen from the dead.
Brothers, Jude here from St. James in the City. Hope you're good. What does Easter mean to me? Well, chocolate eggs are up there, of course, but Easter's the heart of the Christian faith, isn't it? It's Jesus dying on the cross, rising from the dead. It's forgiveness and new life for every person. I particularly like the bit, and some of you will know this, but I particularly like the bit that as Jesus dies, there's this curtain in the temple in Jerusalem. The curtain gets torn in two. And the point is this, the presence of God used to be behind the curtain in the temple. But after Jesus gives his life for us, suddenly the presence of God is available to every person, anytime, any place, down through history. I'm a Christian because I've experienced something of the goodness and the presence of God. And you can too.
Hi, my name's Lydia and I work for Liverpool Youth for Christ. And to me, Easter means that I can have a relationship with God where there's no distance and that I know that he loves me so much and I can go to him freely and for whatever I need, knowing that he is for me and that he loves me with an unconditional love.
Hi, my name's Rob. I'm the pastor of Bethel Church in Liverpool. What does Easter mean to me? Oh, it's the greatest time of the year. I mean, Christmas is great, but Easter to me just offers so much hope. You see, it says to me that death is not the end. You see, Jesus died on the cross, but after 3 days he rose again. And he said to us, where I am now, you will also be, because he is the resurrection and the life. So I know that when I die, I'll be safe forever. The death is not the end. Now you can't get a better message than that. That is the good news of Easter. Also, the eggs are good as well. Have a great Easter.
So I hope you've really enjoyed our Easter service together, albeit virtual this year. We're going to close now with a prayer together. Please join me as we pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the reminder of all the wonderful truth that comes to us through the death and resurrection of your Son, the Saviour of the world, our Lord Jesus Christ. We pray that this Easter of all Easters, we would take hold of that new and living hope which is ours through the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you for your keeping power. Thank you for your sustaining grace. Thank you for your goodness and kindness in sending the Lord Jesus into our world to save and to rescue us. Bless us over this Easter holiday, we pray. May we have rest and relaxation, but may we consider the real meaning of Easter. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. God bless you and your families at this Easter time.